Very good morning, student. How are you? I hope you are well at your home. Today we are taking new chapter, that is three-dimensional geometry, which is very important. We learned what is the meaning and how we can use this three-dimensional geometry in our daily life. So before that, we have to start the subtopics, that is the direction ratio and direction cosine of a line. So let's see. So as earlier we have seen in 11th class, analytic geometry in two dimensional, and also in 11th class we see introduction to three dimensional geometry. And in previous chapter you have already studied about the vector algebra. So when you combine this vector algebra, when we see with the help of the coordinate geometry, that we can say vector algebra to three dimensional geometry we see. And the purpose of this, why we study this vector algebra with the help of 3D, that gives you very easy proof of every geometrical concept. That's why we study the three dimensional geometry in terms of vector. Clear? So here in this chapter you have seen different formula regarding the lines, like whatever we see in two dimension or three dimensional. But here important we see the equation in coordinate geometry as well as equation we see in vector algebra. Both will be simultaneously go throughout the chapter. So we see different type of the equation of the line and distance between the points, or you can say section formula, or plane, or equation of a plane and angle between the lines and angle between the plane and a line, and different type of this shortest distance between a plane and a line. And also we see the foot of perpendicular from a point to the line or a plane, that we have to see. So before that, we are starting our chapter with the topic, that is direction ratio and direction cosine of a line. So from previous chapter or chapter 10, we will see for a line, if we are given a directed line in the three dimensional system, suppose this is x axis, this is y and this is z. And if we are given a directed line L which is passing through the origin, this is passing through the origin, and we are saying that this line L makes the angle with the x axis alpha, y axis beta and z axis gamma. So we call this alpha, beta and gamma are the direction angles. As we see in vector, these are called as the direction angles. Clear? And if we call the cosine of these angles, cosines of these angles, that is cos alpha, cos beta and cos gamma are called the direction cosine. Direction cosine of line L. Now this is directed line L. So all these are called the direction cosine of the directed line L. Now, if we reverse the direction of L, suppose this is the direction of L given to this side. Now, suppose if direction is in this way, this line can be reversed in direction. Then, suppose this angle is alpha we are measuring, then remaining will be this, that is total pi minus alpha. Clear? So we can say this angle will be pi minus alpha. Clear? Similarly, if your this angle is beta, then remaining angle of this line, that is 180 minus beta. और pi minus similarly for this z axis the remaining angle will be pi minus gamma means when we are reversing the direction of the line or if we are given a line which is in both the direction then pi minus alpha pi minus beta and pi minus gamma are the direction angles of line L S dash. Now we are saying L and S means direction is reverse. L to L dash. So its direction cosines are its direction cosines are. So we can say that L equal to cos of angle that is pi minus alpha. L equal to cos pi minus theta. L equal to cos pi minus gamma. So what we get? Minus cos pi that minus cos alpha minus cos beta or minus cos gamma. So we can say this L dash L dash L dash equal to minus L minus L and minus. What is this is L cos alpha M cos beta and cos gamma. So we have one more set of direction cosine that is just sine opposite to previous one. So for if the line given in two direction then the line has two set of the direction cosines. Which one are? One is L and L. Other is minus L, minus L, minus L. Or you may call L dash, M dash, N dash. This is only the sign of the angle will be changed. Clear? So these unique direction cosine. Now for appropriate calculation, generally we take out of this only one direction ratio. That is this L, M, N. Generally we are called the direction cosine of a line is given by formula or by the symbol L cos alpha, M cos beta, L cos gamma. But if anyone says this set is also so we can call this supplementary set of the direction cosine when it is very necessary and it is asked that only we find. Otherwise for other calculation uniquely we have to define direction cosine of line as L cos alpha, L cos beta and N cos gamma. Now we also see in vector that any number which are proportional to this direction cosine that is known as direction ratio. So you can write definition any three number which are proportional to direction cosine of line are called as direction ratio. So what is the meaning of direction ratio? Any number which are proportional to this L and N, proportional to the direction cosine, that is known as the direction ratio of the line. So suppose we call ABC. Let A, B, C are the number such that you may write L equal to AR, M equal to BR and N equal to CR. Then A, B, C are known as then A, B, C are known as direction ratios of the line. Direction ratios of the line. Or one may be also write in this way. Proportional may be in any way. Like you can say this may be given or direction cosine may be divided by direction ratio or direction ratio may be divided by direction cosine, vice versa. So like you can say, they may be like A equal to lambda L, b equal to lambda n, c equal to lambda n, because a upon n equal to lambda, b upon n equal to lambda, c upon n equal to lambda. So you can say a, b, c are the direction ratio. L, M, N are direction cosine. They are proportional because their ratio is equal to lambda. Or we may write A upon L, B upon M, C upon N. Clear? So in this way, we can say these are the direction. Or some may be written like this. Sometimes you may find like this. L upon A, M upon B, or N upon C. This is also proportional. So you may write in this way or you may write in this form. Both are same. Both are proportional to each other. Clear? The ratio may be greater than 1 or it may be less than 1. So one can define the direction ratio and direction. In some author or textbook you find this direction ratio and also direction number. Some textbook you find this direction ratio we call as a direction number. Now there are so many numbers which are proportional to this one. So any number which are proportional to L, M, N, like suppose you can say A, B, C, or you can say 2A, 2B or 2C, or 3A, 3B or 3C, or so many. Or you can say suppose direction cosine is given as 1 to 3. This direction cosine of any line is 1, 2, 3. So any number which is proportional to this one is known as direction ratio. Like if you multiply by 2, 4, 6. If you multiply by 3, if you multiply by 4, and so on. So infinitely number of direction ratio may be there for any line. Clear? So now see, we take some results regarding the relationship between the direction cosine of a line. So we are saying here that let ABC be the direction ratio of the line. Let ABC are the direction ratios of a line and L, M, N are the direction cosine of a line. This is suppose, then by the definition we know that L upon A, M upon B, N upon C, suppose this is K. So one can find the value of L, AK, M, BK, N, CK. And in vector we know that in vector you find a relationship. The sum of square of direction ratio is always equal to 1. L square plus M square plus N square equal to 1. So now put the values of L, M, N. That is AK, BK whole square and CK. So you can take a square common. So what we get? A square, B square. So from this we get the value of K square. So K equal to plus minus 1 upon root of A square, B square, C. So what is the K? That is the ratio of the direction and cosine. So we get the value of K. If you know the value of K, we can find L. So L equal to what? A into K. K means this value. So A into this. So plus minus A upon root of A square plus B square plus C square. M plus minus B upon A square plus B square plus C square. And N equal to plus minus C upon A square plus B square plus C. So what we draw the formula for finding the direction ratio is given. If we are given the direction ratio A, B, C, then how to find direction cosine L and N? So L equal to plus minus A upon root of A square plus B square plus C. M upon plus minus B upon root of A square plus B square plus C. And N equal to plus minus C upon root of A square plus B square plus C. So using this formula, one can find the direction cosine. Clear? So we can now see relation between the direction cosine of line that we already draw. It no need to draw, we have already drawn this relation. See, between the direction cosine of a line, that is same as we draw in the case of the vector, which is L square plus M square plus L square equal to 1. Or you can prove, if you want to prove, that we have already seen here, when you draw this point at P, coordinate x, y, z, and we draw the perpendicular on this axis and this angle between alpha and simplify, we may draw the figure. So that can be drawn, but we have already done, so we are not repeating here. In previous video you see, let's say that is the direction cosine of a line passing through the two points. Direction cosine of a line which passes through the two given points, given points. So suppose we are given two point P with x1, y1, z1, and second point we are given Q with the x2, y2, and z2. So in three dimensional system, we are given this is x axis, y, and z. So we are given this point P and Q. Clear? Its order we can take in this way, first P and then Q. Generally we are taking first P. So coordinate of P is x1, y1, z1, and x2, y2, z2. Clear? Now from this point P, we draw the perpendiculars to the XOY plane. Here we draw the perpendiculars on this plane. This is R. Also we draw perpendicular from this to QS. And this is suppose PN. So we get a right triangle. And also if you extend this, so this is, we are drawing perpendicular, then this line and this line is parallel. And as we know that if you extend this line, the angle from this part will be gamma. Angle of this line, if you extend to pass it through origin, is gamma with the z axis, directed line. So this will be this line parallel to this. This line is now parallel to this. So this work as a transversal. So this angle and this angle will be alternate interior. And if this angle is gamma, then this also gamma. And we are drawing this in 90 degrees. Clear? And we want to find the direction cosine of this line. So you can see that L, M, N are the direction cosine of the line PQ. And what other we have to already result that draw perpendicular and joining of these figure and to consider the right triangle. So in triangle P and Q, in P this angle is gamma, so this is 90, so this is base, and this is perpendicular and this is hypotenuse. So if you want to find the direction cosine, that is value of cos. So cos This is angle of cos gamma equal to base QN upon hypotenuse, that is PQ. Now we can find the QN by coordinate geometry. Suppose this is gamma means which ratio M and L. Because for angle alpha L, beta M and gamma L. So we are taking gamma, it means the direction cosine for L, right? So this will be the Z coordinate. So if you see length QN, that is coordinate of Z coordinate of Q minus Z coordinate of P. So you can write Z2 minus Z1. So QN can be written as Z2 minus Z1 upon PQ. Now you know that in 11th class also find the PQ, that is the distance between two points. So distance between two points using the formula, that is known as distance formula, which we can write as x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1 and z2 minus z1 whole square. So we get the cos gamma. Similarly we write, we write cos beta will be the coordinate of y, so y2 minus y1 upon PQ, and cos alpha, that is x2 minus x1 upon PQ, where PQ is this. So we can find the direction cosine of the line. So you can write as the direction cosine of line with passing through the two given points is given by, you may write a formula, is given by. So L equal to cos alpha equal to x2 minus x1 upon PQ. N equal to cos theta y2 minus y1 upon PQ, and N equal to cos gamma, that is z2 minus z1 upon PQ, where PQ equal to this, that is root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square plus z2 minus z1 whole. So dear student, if you are given the two point from which a line passes through, then we can find the direction cosine of the line. If you know the direction cosine, we can find the direction ratio of the line. Because here the number which is proportional to this, if you remove the PQ or if you multiply all these by PQ, we get the number what? X2 minus X1, y2 minus y1, z2 minus z1. So one can also write the direction ratio of this line and direction ratio of PQ are x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1, z2 minus z1. This is. So when we are given the two point from which a line passes through, we can find the direction ratio and direction cosine. So this is all. Now we see here some examples related to these topics, how to solve some question using this formula. So you may write first example, if a line match angle, max angles 90 degree, 60 degree and 30 degree with positive direction of x axis, y axis and z axis respectively, then find the direction cosine. You have to find
Acer direction cosine.
So we are given the direction, angle is given, and we have to find the direction cosine.
So very easy. We write let L, M, N are direction cosine of the line with alpha, beta, gamma are direction angles. Direction angles. Then we know that direction cosine L is equal to L cos alpha, M equal to cos beta, and N equal to cos gamma.
Now alpha is the angle formed by the line with the x axis, which is given 90.
So we can write cos 90, and value of cos 90 is 0.
Beta is the angle formed by the line with the y axis, which is given as 60.
So we can write cos 60, and value of cos 60 is 1/2, and then cos gamma, that is 30, which is √3/2.
So what we get, that our values are 0, 1/2, and √3/2. This is the direction cosine. Now let's say example second.
If you write, if a line has direction ratio, if a line has direction ratio, we are writing in short form dr dash s, this direction ratio, 2 - 1, 2, determine its direction cosine, determine its direction cosine. So in solution we know if L, M, N are direction cosine and A, B, C are direction ratios of a line, then we give the formula L equal to plus minus A upon root of A square plus B square plus C square, and N equal to plus minus B upon A square, B square, C square, and N equal to plus minus C upon. So here we are what given? Here A equal to 2, B equal to minus 1, and C equal to 2. So we find the value of root of A square, B square, C square. So 2 square 4 plus 4 plus 1, that is 3. So now put this value, A is 2. So L equal to plus minus 2 upon 3, M equal to B upon, B is minus 1, so minus plus, sign will change, 1 upon 3, N equal to 2 upon 3, are the required direction cosine of a line. So dear student, if one can given the direction ratio, we have to find the direction cosine of the line. Next example, find the direction cosine of a line passes through the points. Now we are given points P with the coordinate minus 4, 4, minus 5, and Q 1, 2, 3. So we have already given this formula. Let L, M, N are direction cosine of the given line, given line PQ. Then if these direction cosines are given by formula,
एल इक्वल टू एक्स टू, एन इक्वल टू वाई टू माइनस वाई वन, एन इक्वल टू जेड टू माइनस जेड वन पी, वेयर पी क्यू इक्वल टू रूट ऑफ एक्स टू माइनस एक्स वन, वाई टू माइनस वाई वन एंड जेड टू माइनस जेड वन. सो पुट ऑल दी वैल्यू एंड सिंप्लीफाइड. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ पी क्यू यूजिंग डिस्टेंस फॉर्मूला. सो पी क्यू इक्वल टू रूट ऑफ एक्स टू माइनस एक्स वन, वन माइनस वन, वन माइनस माइनस दैट इज थ्री स्क्वायर, वाई टू टू माइनस फोर दैट इज माइनस टू स्क्वायर, जेड टू माइनस जेड वन थ्री प्लस एट स्क्वायर. सो टेन स्क्वायर एड दैट विल गिव यू रूट 77. कैलकुलेट दिस वन. नाउ पुट इन दिस फॉर्मूला एल एक्स टू माइनस एक्स वन, वन प्लस टू दैट इज थ्री अपॉन 77, एंड वाई टू माइनस वाई वन टू माइनस टू माइनस टू अपॉन 77, एंड जेड टू माइनस जेड वन एट अपॉन रूट. सो दीज आर द डायरेक्शन कोसाइन आर द रिक्वायर्ड डायरेक्शन कोसाइन ऑफ द लाइन पी क्यू. सो डियर स्टूडेंट, इन दिस वे वन कैन फाइंड द डायरेक्शन कोसाइन ऑफ द लाइन. नाउ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन इज देयर, एग्जाम्पल फोर, फाइंड द डायरेक्शन कोसाइन ऑफ एक्स वाई एंड जेड. Now we want to find the direction cosine of the axis itself. So you can see here, suppose this is x, this is y and this is z. Now we want to find direction cosine of x. So angle of x with the x, that is 0. Angle of the x with the y, 90. Angle x, x axis with the z axis, that is 90. So direction angles are 0, 90 and 90. So we can write, since x axis makes angle 0, 90 and 90 with itself, or you can say x axis. So direction cosine x equal to cos 0, n equal to cos 90, n equal to cos 90, that is cos 0 1 90 0 0. So this is the direction cosine of the x axis. Similarly, y axis makes angle y axis with the x 90, y with y 0, y with z that is 90. So direction cosines are cos 90, cos 0 and cos 90, that is cos 90 0 1 0, and z axis direction cosine are now cos z axis with the x axis that is 90, z axis with the y 90, z to z 0, that is 0 0 1. So in this way we can find the direction cosine of the line. Clear? So dear student, in this way we can find the direction cosine of the coordinate axis. Clear? One more problem, so that the points, we see one more problem or last of this topic. See here, so that the points, so that the points. Now we are given 3 points. A 2 3 minus 4 and B 1 minus 4 3 1 minus 4 3 and C 3 8 11 3 8 minus 11 are collinear. You have to prove these are collinear. So we prove this with the help of direction ratio or direction cosine. Clear? So we can find the direction ratio of the line. Direction ratio of the line joining A and B. Now direction ratio of this x2 minus x1, 1 minus 2, y2 minus 1, and z2 minus z1. So 3 minus minus plus. That is minus 1, minus 5, and 7. Now direction ratio of the line. We also find the direction ratio of the line joining B and C. Now B and C, 3 minus 1, 8 minus minus plus, minus 11 minus 3. That is 2, 10 and minus 14. Now we scrutinize the relationship between these ratios. So you can say it is clear from that the ratio of AB and BC are proportional. It is clear that the ratio of AB and BC are proportional. Why proportional? If you multiply this by minus 2, if this ratio is multiplied by minus 2, so minus 1 minus 4, 2, minus 5 minus 4, 10, 7 into minus 4, that is minus 14. That's why we can say ratio are proportional, hence AB is a parallel to BC. Hence AB is parallel to BC. But B is a common, like if you say AB is parallel to BC, B is a common. It means AB parallel to BC means a coincide point B. That is the B is a common. But B is common point. Here point B is a common in both A and B. Therefore, in both line AB and BC. Therefore, AB are collinear points. So we can say they are collinear point as two. So with the help of ratio, one can also prove that either the points are collinear or not. So dear students, this is all about today's class. To be continued with us for more videos. Thanks for watching today's video. Have a nice day.